Okay, we're starting to get towards the end, and there's always things that you can jump ahead and finish whenever you want. Now, today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take care of the skin and faces. I'm going to teach you two different ways. One's a little bit more difficult than the other, but we'll go ahead and handle that as we get there. Now, the first way that I'm going to do it is I'm going to use the layering of paint as a way to show just how well layering paint can be to bring out a sort of depth. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start with vomit brown. I'm going to move it to a bronze flesh. I'm going to very lightly use a highlight of bleach bone and then white. Now remember, if you don't have the exact colors that you want, that's fine because you can always mix and match the paints. Then after I do the first one, we'll look at the results and then we'll do the second one, which will be a little bit easier. But before we get there, let's go ahead and do this one. Okay, now that we have the first layer done, we're gonna go ahead and put on the second layer. We're gonna primarily cover about 90% of it. It looks like a little bit of a redundancy, but what it'll actually do is actually give depth to the miniature. The only areas that we're actually leaving is the very shallowest. Now we're gonna put on our third coat, which is gonna cover about 80% of the skin area. And that's gonna be the elf flesh. So it'll lighten up most of the areas a little bit more, but we're still gonna leave quite a bit for depth. Now, any area that I can't just touch with a brush, I don't wanna have to force my way in there, that'll actually add the depth that we're looking for with the figure. Now we're gonna put on our fourth layer for the skin. This is just gonna be a highlight. It's gonna be one of two highlights. Basically what I'm doing now is I'm gonna look for the raised areas, cheekbones, down the nose. Those are the areas that are easiest to hit and will also make the figure look better. I'm gonna give it a full stroke wide as I'm passing over to paint it. And in doing so, it'll bring out the characteristics of the character. And you can also dab a little bit here and there. Just makes it look like he has a little bit of glare. As it is, the guy doesn't have any hair on his head. So we're not gonna make fun of old people, but we'll just say that sometimes it's there. The last thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my brush, I'm gonna use a little bit of skull white. Now we used a full stroke wide when we used the bleach bone. Now with the white, we're just barely gonna touch over the areas that we used the bleach bone. This is gonna add yet another layer of depth to the character. And it really looks like it will really bring it. Just remember, any area that you want, you can always cover up, add a lot of depth to it. And in this case, even if you think that you have a piece that you need to go back, you put it on a little bit too much highlight, it's very easy to cover up, it's very easy to fix. So it's not a problem, and you can always mix and match and do it until you get it right. Don't worry about the layers are only going to make it look better. Now, a lot of people, they'll put on one color, they probably would have started with elf flesh, went straight to the white as a highlight. The more layers that you have, the more contrast it has, the better it's going to look. Now, the next step, after we've went ahead and painted over it primarily, we're gonna add a wash to it. What the wash is basically gonna do, it's gonna add a slight coloration, but it's gonna take all the shading in and do it itself. Basically what a wash does is it's so light that any of the cracks or crevices finds itself and most of the wash will fill in for you. It takes a little bit longer to dry than the regular paints do, but it's well worth it. Now, one of the major advantages to doing or using the washes is if you can see the figure, you can already see where some of the ridges are exposed. It's almost as if none of the wash remained on that area. So I can always go over that area, expand it a little bit, and I know exactly where all my valleys are. on my guy. I'm using the exact same paint as the original base coat. My original prime. Sorry. I'm using the exact same paint as my primary paint. Now, once I've done this, I've left the wash areas alone where it built up the most. I went ahead and went back over it and just hit 90% or 80% of it with the regular coloration that I wanted to begin with, but it showed me where the areas that I needed to be dark were. Now I can just go through, throw in a little bit of a highlight, and I'm already done. It's a lot quicker, it's a lot easier to use the washes, and it also makes it much easier because you can actually see the peaks and the valleys of the areas that you're trying to do.